This instructional video demonstrates the appropriate laboratory techniques to prepare a sample of groundnuts to determine the aflatoxin content using Neogen Reveal Q Plus lateral flow test strips and the mobile assay M reader. A grinder to prepare the sample, a scale and a timer, a container with a lid to shake the sample, pipetters and pipette tips to measure the sample in diluent, and graduated cylinders or bulb pipetters to measure the 65% ethanol extraction solution. Pink and clear sample cups, a small bottle of diluent, test strips, and the tablet reader with case and sample holder. Now, let's get started. First, the groundnut sample must be ground to a fine particle size. Be sure to grind the entire sample. Sampling technique and adequate sample size are very important to assure accurate results. A manual grinder can be used as long as the particle size is consistent and very fine. Here, we use an electric blender and several small batches to grind the entire sample. From the ground material, weigh a 10-gram subsample. Next, measure 30 milliliters of a 65% ethanol solution and add this to the test portion in a jar with a sealable lid. Vigorously shake the jar with the mixture for 3 minutes. Filter the sample. Next, using a pipette, add 500 microliters of diluent solution into the pink cuvette. A bottle of diluent solution, a pink cuvette, and a clear cuvette are provided with the test strips. Next, using another pipette, add 100 microliters of the filtered sample into the same pink cuvette. Mix the sample in diluent by stirring and pipetting the solution 4 to 5 times. Now, using another pipette, take 100 microliters of the mixed solution and add it to the provided clear cuvette. Next, place the test strip into the cuvette. There is an arrow on the strip indicating the direction in which the strip should be inserted into the test solution. Leave the strip in the cuvette for 5 minutes. Remove the strip and place it into the holder so the test indicator lines face the tablet camera. Timing is important when reading the strip and should be done quickly, approximately 6 minutes after it was initially inserted into the solution. Be certain that the tablet is on and the app is prepared so that the data will be named and stored in the appropriate folder. Be certain that the test indicator lines are centered over the camera, as demonstrated. Notice that the white line is centered between the peaks. When it is positioned correctly, tap on the Capture Data icon. Make sure that the data is associated with the correct standard, or it could be interpreted incorrectly. Your data is now stored on the device and will sync with the cloud when connected to the internet.